Hello and welcome to this Hyro tutorial. My name is Laura and I'm going to give you a quick overview on Hyro storytelling software. First, we are going to have a look at the interface. Afterwards, we are going to create a story and I will show you how you can collaborate with your colleagues. Let's get started. Once you're logged in, you will land on this page. It's called the dashboard page, and here you can edit your profile. On the left side, you will see the menu list. Here you have your stories, here you have the scene library, your media libraries, your background library, and the settings, which is accessible for the administrator of the platform. Let's create our first story. You go to New Story, and here you can fill in some details of the story. For example, your title, the location. At the moment, we are in the purple office. And in the purple office, we have different setups where we can create stories for. Let's pick the Pop IX. The Pop IX is a 360 projection room with four walls. You can use it for awesome storytelling. And then other setups. I will dive into that later. Some custom filters, so I can set the importance of the story, and we are creating this for the marketing department. Create. So this is the story editor, and here you can see the canvas with your wall 1, wall 2, wall 3, and wall 4. On the right side, you see the side panel with every item that you can add to your scene. Here you can see the scene list, and here you can see the asset list. Here, you can see the media toolbar. And the media toolbar changes based upon what asset you have selected. So imagine we are creating a story for the marketing department of Purple. We are going to give a little demo. We would like to talk something about Purple. And we would like to welcome our users. So let's first start with the demo scene. In the demo scene, I would like to blow away my visitors. So I'm going to add an awesome video. For example, this demo video. Then, next to that, I would like to welcome my visitors. So I'm going to create a welcome scene. I'm going to create and add a background again. Now I would like to add some assets. I go to Add Media, and here I have three different libraries. I have my private library, I have the company library, and I have the background library. My media library is my private library, and all the assets that I upload into this media library are personal, so no one can access them. Then we have the company media library. And this company media library consists of company assets. For example, a logo, some standardized videos that you can use about the brand, or maybe some standard shapes which have a particular color of your brand. I would like to upload some media. So you click on Upload Media, upload files from my computer, and here I can select some assets. I can create or add videos, I can add images, PowerPoints, PDFs, I can add sound, and I can add URL assets. So for example, I add the website purple.nl. There we go. Next to that, I would like to add a video. Yes. So I just uploaded some media to my private library, and now I'm going to add it to my scene. I would like to add this video, for example. So what I do, I drag and drop it on my canvas, and then I can set it to the right position. Then I'm going to create an about page. Okay, so I add a background again, and now I'm going to add some assets. This one. Oh. If you want to undo stuff, you just comment Z. You can multi-select assets and then you can align them from each other with the alignment tool. So you click on position and then you can click on middle and on horizontal. I would like to add the world map because this is where we're represented. And I would like to add some steps and how we are going to get there. If your room or the screen that you're using for your presentation is touch enabled, you can use on-click actions. On-click actions can make your presentation way more interactive because you can touch upon the wall and then something is happening because you attached a particular on-click action to an asset. There are two different types of on-click actions. You have go to and toggle on off. Go to always switches to a different scene and toggle on off turns on and off assets in that particular scene. If you select the media asset, then the on-click action will show up in the media toolbar where you can select this action. Let's start with the go to. So here I select go to and then I can select the target. Let's say next scene. Every time I click on this green asset, when I'm in the room, I will switch to the next scene. Then, next asset. When I select this one, I go to the on-click actions feature again and I click on toggle on off. And then I can select the target asset. So let's say I would like to launch the orange one. Okay. So every time I'm now clicking on this purple asset, when I'm in the room, the orange asset will be launched. So we just created some scenes, we added some interaction, we added some media, and now I would like to add some smooth transitions in between. Let's go to the demo scene. In the demo scene, we added a video, and after the demo video, I would love the scene to switch automatically to the next scene. So I go to the scene, and I go to scene settings. In the scene settings, we have the auto switch toggle. When I turn this on, the scene will automatically go to the next scene once the background video is done playing. Then another transition is via the add transition feature. Here I can add some transitions and I can just drag and drop it again on my canvas. On the right side, I can set transition time, let's say 5 seconds, and I can choose for a loop. What is good to know is that when you add a transition, it will always play before the scene you added it to. So at the moment, I added it to the About Purple page, which means that this transition will play when I go from the Welcome to the About Purple page. So we just created our story. We created some scenes, we uploaded some assets, we added some transitions, we added some interactions. And what is good to know is that everything is saved automatically within the story editor. There is one more feature I would love to show you guys. Nowadays, we're working from everywhere. And that's why it's really nice that you can collaborate with your colleague in the story. So I'm going to invite my colleague Pim because I would love to share my story with him. If you go to the top right corner, there you can invite a colleague. There you can search for his email address and then you can send an invite. When you send an invite, an email will be sent and he can access the story via his email inbox. Next to that, he can access the story via his story list as well. Let me show you. So there's this little icon behind the story title, and when you hover on top of that, you can see that there are collaborators added to your story. So if there's no icon, you know that this is a personal story. So to summarize, now you know how to create a story, how to add interactions, and how to invite your colleague. Now it's time for you to create your story. Thank you for watching.